My cat's trying to steal my bagel. No, this is my bagel, and I am on my bagel break. Whoa, what's up? It's Different Day Jazzy. Since I have a lot of items to go through, I had to film on a different day just because I easily get emotionally and physically drained. Now, onwards to pants! So the order that I'm gonna go through with these pants is first dress pants or more like fancy pants, and then slowly go into my hammer pants and then jeans. So first one up is my vintage white dress pants with a pleat down the middle, and it really gives you that like businesswoman kind of feel. And this is by JBT. This next vintage pants I actually got off of Depop, and I was trying to look for more off-white kind of dress pants, so I ended up finding these. And this is by Petite Sophisticate. It's so weird because I am not petite at all, but whenever I find like petite items, I just grab it because why not? And usually it still fits me. Oh, this is petite as well. This one is vintage purple pants. I like the style of it. And this is by Pinstripe from the line Petites. Next up are these vintage blue pants. And this is by Corette Francisca. Next up are these hot pink, I believe nylon is the material that windbreakers are made out of. I could be wrong. This is sort of a windbreaker pants. It does not actually go with any windbreaker that I do own. So another pair of pink pants, but it is in more of a salmon kind of pink. So you may remember Haband or Haband. Looks like we're on a roll because these are also by Haband. Now this is a nice pair of pastel yellow pants. Now it looks like we are finally transitioning to my hammer pants. Now with these hammer pants, I know a lot of people ask where I get them, and it's usually either eBay or Depop, but they go for, wow, an insane amount of money that at the time I was willing to pay. Now this is one of my favorites. It has a great color combination and has a really neat design. And these pants are by Sinbad. Next up is this amazing pair of international baggies pant. It has zigzag patterns with neon colors on it, and I just absolutely love this one. Next up is an incredibly unique design. It doesn't have a brand name, sadly, but it's just so unique and one of a kind. I just love it. Now this one is just purely all blue designed with bits of black and white. This one is by Athletic Works. Now we are done with that. We are moving on to jeans. Now I got these pastel floral jeans off of Etsy. Actually don't fit me that well. I'm trying to make it work somehow. And this is by Hunt Club. Now this is my most worn pants because it is just a regular straight leg, high-waisted acid wash jeans. Now I'm actually pretty sure that this isn't vintage. It is by PacSun. I know PacSun has been around since like the 80s and 90s, but this seems more like an imitation of retro mom jeans. However, it is still one of my favorites and I wear it all the time. Now, these are some high-waisted, light acid wash jeans, and they have some pleatings here on the pocket and some paneling on the pants. And it even has buttons on the pant cuffs. These are by Nuovo Industrial. Nuovo is a pretty good brand. I actually really like them and I have a few items from them, and they always end up becoming my favorite piece of clothing. Now, I also wear this a lot. It is my high-waisted pleated jeans in a dark blue material. And this is pretty much the only vintage piece from Lee that I have. Now, these jeans are the most popular thing in the 80s community. Now, I know I said I wasn't gonna mention any modern brand names, but this is by Wild Fable. It is from Target. These are an imitation of 80s mom's jeans in a light acid wash style. It even has the V paneling here, and it also has the same thing in the back. One of my other jeans that I'm gonna show you next also has this, so you know that these pairs of jeans did the research. Hello again to these jeans you already just saw. They are by Jordache. I love these because I don't have jeans like this in my wardrobe that is actually very fitted at the waist and then slowly just goes off to a balloon baggy kind of style. I don't wear these often. They are a little baggy-ish on me, but they are the only fold-over jeans that I have. It's very hard to find these style of jeans, especially in my size. I'm a size 24-25, and that doesn't come easy online. They actually don't have a tag, so I can't mention the brand. Now, these jeans I just recently got off of eBay, and it has an amazing paneling on the pants, and it is high-waisted. Now that we got the jeans out of the way, the last pair of pants I want to show you is my black stirrup pants. These are vintage and in really good condition, and it fits me quite well. I enjoy wearing these when I have a sweater on, and this pair is by Hunk Club. It is a tennis uniform with shorts and a top. This is by Peter Popovich. Now, I completely forgot that I had this, but I have a woman's vintage three-piece suit, and it comes with a pencil skirt as well as pants. Personally, I would gravitate towards the pants than the skirt. And this is by Casual Corner. Now, this next one is an 80s teal and purple two-piece. It is 100% made of silk, and it is very comfortable. Now, this one is pretty awesome. It is a two-piece set. It has the pencil skirt as well as the blazer, and this was given to me by my friend in the 80s community, Adrian. So if you're watching this, hello and thank you. I love this very much. I was actually really surprised that she got my measurements right. I have no idea. She's probably psychic. Here we are with another two-piece suit. This one has the pants and then the blazer. The pants I wear from time to time, but I do get a real kick out of this blazer because it really makes me feel like I am in Miami Vice. And this is by Jacqueline Smith. Now, this one you saw in my thrift haul video from last year. It is a two-piece of a blazer and a skirt. Don't really get much wear out of the top, but I like wearing the skirt a lot. And this is by Matthew and David for BL. Now, this one you probably might remember from my winter lookbook. It is this two-piece, a batwing quarter sleeve top with matching skirt. It does actually have a matching belt with it, but it doesn't fit me. But I will try to show you guys how it looks like with the entire set. Now, this next one is a pastel striped set with a top and bottom. You guys may have already seen this in my perm video. I wore this outside with my brand new perm, just give it that 80s vibes. And I love this set. I love tucking in the top into the pants. It looks a lot more flattering that way. Kind of reminds me of this one picture of a girl wearing something a little similar. And this is by I Am Smart Alec California. This is a nuovo two-piece set of high-waisted shorts and a top. I actually don't have any light wash pants, so I was really glad to get this set. And the top is very cute. It is cropped at the bottom, and it has a really nice pattern design at the top. Now, quick callback, I think these shorts remind me a lot of the Target 80s imitation mom jeans, because if you look at these, they're almost quite similar, and this is just sort of like the shorts version of those pants. This is also going to be a very small section, which I call It just includes clothes that are blazers, vests, one-piece items, basically, overalls. I am gonna sound like a dang parrot, but you guys already seen this in my closet cleanout.
Jesus Christ, is that you?
We have this very long kind of robe style dress, and this is by Casper ASL. Next up is the white dress from the same video, and this is by Abby Kent. Now, this dress is the last of the dresses in the pile, and this is a very unique dress. It fits me very well. It comes with a very snug belt, which accentuates my waist, and very large shoulder pads. And this is by Karen Stevens. Now onto this top, which I thrifted not too long ago. I feel like there was supposed to be a matching bottom part, like maybe a skirt, but I just couldn't find it. And this fits me really nicely. I love the shoulder pad and puff sleeves. And this is from Nana Collections by Jonathan Tate. Now here's a striped colorful blazer that I got off of Etsy a long, long time ago. And this I hardly ever wear, but I really do like the design and the fact that it is colorful and has giant buttons on it. And this is by Sag Harbor. Next up are vests. So I thrifted this denim vest a couple months ago and I really like it. I like the fact that it has embroidered flowers on the collar and on a small patch at the back. And this is by LA Blues. Now this blue denim vest I thrifted very early on as well. And I like the fact that, again, it has embroidered flowers. I feel like that is a trend to things that I like. This is by Stony Brook. Next one is this vest that also has embroidered flowers. Surprise, surprise. And this one gives me very strong Sarah vibes from Labyrinth. This is by Casey and Max. This next vest I thrifted very recently and I have yet to wear it, but I think it is pretty cool. I really like the neutral toned colors and I think the buttons are very cute. This is by Styled in Italy Cafe. This vest is actually one of my favorites of all the vests. And I actually went actively looking for this on eBay right after I saw WandaVision. And also at the very exact same time I was watching Are You Afraid of the Dark for the very first time, this girl had a very good sense of style and I really like how she paired one of her vests with a very long skirt. And I just thought that was so cute. Now for the last two will be overalls. I only own two overalls and hopefully maybe in the future I'll own a little bit more. But for now I just have these. So I got this actually from Allison, and if you know her, she used to go by Color Club at the time, and she was selling one of these overalls, and I thought this was so cute, and I ended up buying it from her shop. I know she's not into the 80s and 90s style anymore, but you guys have her to thank because she's the sole reason why I even started this YouTube channel. For the last item is my other overalls. This is my light wash denim overalls, which are pretty cool, if I may say. The very inside has a floral pattern and rose buttons that goes with the floral theme. And it's by Nuovo Industrial. And now we made it to the shorts and skirt section. I have a lot more shorts than I do skirts. And the first ones up are athletic shorts that I got off of Amazon a long time ago. Now I'm gonna be showing you the only two denim skirts that I own. This one is a floral skirt, which I got off of eBay, as well as one of my friends, Grace, from the 80s community, and we actually did a collab together last year. I'll put up a picture. And it is by one of the popular 80s brands, Firenze. Now, when I tell you I have been wearing this acid wash denim skirt that I got from eBay, I am not exaggerating at all. This is my baby, okay? I have been on record saying I don't wear skirts, but oh my God, this skirt is the exception. This is something I want to die with. Onto my actual shorts now. First one we got is this bright red pleated short. By the way, I absolutely love 80s shorts, especially pleated shorts, because it always has such a nice fitted waist and then just balloons out. These shorts are by In Short. I've been trying to find a tan or khaki colored shorts for a while now, and I've just been in that like Friday the 13th summer counselor kind of mood. I've actually just been styling this by cuffing up the bottoms of the pants. Here we have lilac pleated shorts, and it is by Cheryl Teagues. Now, Cheryl Teagues was a very popular supermodel in the 70s, and in the early 80s, she had her own fashion line, and these shorts were from that exact line. Now, these white pleated shorts are the longest shorts that I have. I try not to wear these shorts as often because I don't want to stain them. There are a few stains on here, but that's from when I got them and I tried washing them out, but you know how stains are. They are by Mark Shale. Now these next two shorts are ones that you've already seen in my summer lookbook that I just released, and these are the pink pleated shorts. It is by David Smith. Now, whenever I wear these shorts, they are pretty popular and get everyone's attention, and I completely understand that. Granted, these shorts have such a unique and fantastic design on them. It is just a smidge baggy on me. It does sit more at my hips than my waist. But usually what I do with that is just put a belt over it and I'm good to go. And this is by Sieste Olivia. Now these are neon yellow shorts, and at the bottom here it does have a really cool graphic font that says Miami Beach. And these were off of the Color Club shop as well, and this is by Uzi. Now these shorts are not vintage, but I really like the color combination of these shorts. It is by Nike's, and I'm guessing it's like waterproof shorts that you could wear while swimming or at the beach. Now these very last shorts I believe are more like beach shorts, and I absolutely love the design. It has neon colors in the shape of sunglasses. And this is by Safi's, which I'm guessing is sort of like a normal apparel clothing company like jerseys or Fruit of the Loom. He honked and he's like, we gotta go. I'm like, where are we going? He's like, we gotta go. And we ended up in space. And then we were in this intergalactic space war. I got in the crossfire. There was hands thrown, there was paws thrown. And for some weird reason, the Babadook was there. I don't know how and I don't know why, but surprisingly, he was really chill. And we ended up winning, we had a big feast, and I ended up coming back to my house. because damn, it was really split open. So that was about 3 weeks ago. First up is this pastel windbreaker. I mean, just look at it, it's so wonderful and cute. And this jacket is by Bay Club. Next one is this windbreaker. This one actually has shoulder pads in it. Most of my windbreakers do not. And I thrifted this jacket mainly because of the very earthy tones that it has. And this is by Adeline by Alfred Dunner. Now this beauty is actually one of my first windbreakers that I started in my collection. I bought it off of Etsy as well as another jacket, which I'll show in a little bit. I did feature this piece in my winter lookbook and I didn't know the brand's name, but luckily someone in the comments did mention it to me and I am super thankful for that, so I will put the name up on screen. Now this funky windbreaker that I thrifted has become one of my ultimate favorites because the inside has the softest material I have ever worn in a windbreaker. It does run super baggy on me, but I don't mind that at all. And this is by Active Code. Now this is the coat that I was mentioning that I also bought with the color block windbreaker. And this one is just as cool because it is a reversible jacket. So you can flip it inside out and the other side would be a pink windbreaker material. So I never knew how much I was going to love the vintage reversible jackets until I started seeing them pop up at the thrift store that I went to. So I got this one as well. It is in red and on the reverse side is a blue windbreaker material. This tan colored jacket with the plaid on the inside, I've already shown in my room tour and it is one of my absolute favorites. I sound like a broken record at this point, but in that video I did mention that this coat looks exactly like the one that Clark Kent wore in Superman 2. Just lives rent free in my mind constantly. And this coat is by JCPenney. Now this last coat is a members only jacket. It is not a vintage one, but it looks close enough to one. At the time, I was trying to look for a vintage one, but I could never really find one in a color that I liked, or it was a little bit over my budget. So I ended up getting this one instead, and I am very happy with it. I love the color and the fit of it. Dang, I'm gonna be real honest with you guys. I have no idea what this is. Either way, it was worth the $5 that I spent on this because it is so ugly that it comes back around and just ends up being kind of cute. I mean, there's bits of lace. There is some really interesting threading designs. I love the ribbon on it, and some of the material is actually very felty. I mean, like, the color vomit is so bad that it's good. And this is by Studio Works. Now this denim jacket is one of the first that I thrifted. It is an X large. It is baggy on me, but very comfortable. I think the design is so neat. I love the flowers on it and the butterflies. I mean, look at it, even the buttons are really cute. And this one is by White Stag. Now this might just look like a plain blue denim jacket, but it is actually a vintage Disney jacket. I really like the way that this fits on me. It is super simple and casual. And the only thing that'll trip you off that it's a Disney product is the little Mickey Mouse head on the buttons. Now this one is actually one of my favorites that I own. I don't know, just like the design overall and the way that it fits on me is super 80s in my opinion. And even my mom said that this reminded her of something similar that she used to wear back in the day. This is by Odyssey Collection. I am fully aware that I said that that denim jacket is one of my favorites. Let it be clear, that is my favorite denim jacket, but this one is my favorite acid wash denim jacket. Ever since I bought this off of eBay, I got attached to it very fast. I just like to mention that some of the material is already peeling off, like on the cuffs and on this part right here on the jacket are slowly ripped already and worn out. However, in my mind, that doesn't deflate the value of it. I still love it a lot. And this one is by Ruth Douglas. Now this jacket I purchased at the end of the winter season, so I never was able to wear it, but I'm hoping to wear it this season. It is a very thick denim jacket. I think the design is really nice. I love the front here where it has a sort of a windbreaker material to it, and then also the floral tapestry. And this one is by Weathered Blues. Same thing to this one. I got this one at the very end of the last winter season and haven't worn it yet. It is this cropped light acid wash jacket. When I saw the measurements, I knew it was gonna be cropped, but when it came in and I actually saw the size of it, I almost thought it was a kid's jacket. I was a little bamboozled from that. I ended up messaging the seller and asking, hey, is this a kid's jacket? And they clarified to me that no, it is not. The quarter sleeves were purposeful because back in the 80s, girls would wear jackets like these to show off their bangle bracelets or just bracelet and accessories. And I was like, oh, okay, wow, that made so much sense. Why didn't I think of that before? Now this is the last denim jacket that I have to show you guys. This one is also one of my favorites. It is a Jordache acid wash jacket. It is very big and long on me, but I love that because to me it screams really 80s when something is baggy. And I've gotten many compliments on this jacket. I actually recently wore this to the Harry Styles concert in Chicago with my sister. And when we were at my friend's hotel, these two ladies that were already seated there went off about my outfit. They said I look like Kelly from Saved by the Bell. I don't see it personally, but I can totally see why they were like, oh wow, that's very early 90s fashion that you're wearing. We love it. They were just honestly so sweet and really made my day. I only have 3 coats left to show you guys, so let's get on to finishing this section. So this is a really thick and big coat. I love the colors. First off, it's great. It's a ski jacket just from the way that it's designed with multiple zippers and pouches and things like that. I'm gonna be honest, I don't really know why I thrifted this. I don't wear this that often. I only wore it once just for fun, but I think it's just the design. I really enjoy how this looks aesthetically. This one is by Cabin Creek.
A second, future Jazzy here. Was anybody going to tell me that this is actually a two-piece?
How am I just now figuring this out? I am so f***ing dumb. How did I just realize? I already showed this coat in my closet clean out with friends, and it makes me look like a giant marshmallow because it is so large, but my friends say that I should still keep this either way. And even if I'm not gonna wear it, I really do just love having this one in my collection. Now, the very last piece of clothing that I have to show you is this jacket. I actually wore this jacket a lot ever since I thrifted it, and I wore it all winter as well. It has a very cool design on the back. It says Arctic Zone. Bonus points for this because this is a reversible jacket. On the inside, you can flip it over and it's all white. And that concludes the end of the video. I was actually debating whether or not I should show my belt collection, which isn't a lot, by the way. Since this video is probably already long, I was like, nah, I won't show it. I worked very hard on this one and it was a lot of fun to just try on my clothes and show you guys my collection. By the way, if you're new and you really like all the 80s content that I have, don't be shy to subscribe. Comment down below what your favorite piece of clothing was, because I would like to know, and remember to leave a like as well. I hope you all have a great week and remember to take care of yourselves. I'll see you all in the next video. Bye!
He's modest.
You'd never beat me if this were for real.
She's meek.
Is that so?
Alvin and Brittany are made for each other.
You're joking, right?
And now...
Stop, you creep!
Run!
They're really going places.
You better believe it!
They're the hottest couple in show business.
We've got to keep these two apart.
In their first motion picture adventure, The Chipmunk Adventure, starts Friday at a theater near you.